Welcome to the program. I'm your host, Neil Howard, here on Health Professional Radio. Glad that you could join us today. Going to have a conversation with a woman who's got a distinguished practice. She's a chemist and a pharmacist. Joining us today to talk about some of the myths, some of the facts surrounding essential oils and supplements, as well as their benefits. Please welcome to the program, Dr. Lindsay Elmore. Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me here today.
Now, as a chemist and a pharmacist, give us just a bit of your background, and let's talk about essential oils and other supplements.
So I am originally from Birmingham, Alabama. I have a degree in chemistry from the University of Alabama, Birmingham, and then I have my doctorate in pharmacy from the University of California, San Francisco. Did 2 years postdoc, one in internal medicine, and then my second year postdoc was in ambulatory care. And when I was in ambulatory care, I saw patients with the disease states that everybody has, diabetes, hypertension, hyperlipidemia, asthma, COPD. And I would sit with patients and we would aim to change their life. How do we make them healthier people? And one of the things that became very frustrating for me as a pharmacist is people say they want to change their life, but then they don't really take any action to empower those choices. And so I started just giving people other options, and I started doing tons of research about essential oils, herbs, supplements, their interactions with medications, their interactions with disease states, because I felt like there was a relative lack of understanding among healthcare providers about how do we, if we choose to, integrate these two worlds. And I felt like patients were asking the questions and not finding answers. And so I went about trying to find the best answers that I could, and sometimes those answers are, hey, there's great evidence. Sometimes those answers are, there's really not good evidence at all. So that's a bit of my background, and now I speak and teach people about essential oils online and on stages around the world.
So how do you end up talking to your patients about these alternative medicines, these essential oils and other supplements? And, you know, you're a pharmacist, but you're talking about herbs and some of these other things that could be considered alternative. How do you get that conversation started and build some trust in this alternative?
Sure. So one of the things that I think is so important for healthcare professionals is we must ask our patients about alternative medicines, because a lot of the times, especially in varieties of cultures and races and ethnicities, people are shy about telling you what kind of herbs and supplements that they're using. So step one, we as professionals have to say, tell me more. I see that you've listed these medicines here. Do you take any herbs, any supplements, any remedies that your mother gave to you? Ask it in a wide variety of ways, because once we get the patient talking, then we will open up the conversation and the dialogue. And then once you have that dialogue open, it's so important to be respectful and non-judgmental. I think it's a tragedy when patients walk in to their primary care provider or their family medicine doctor or even a dentist or whoever, and they say, hey, I've got this bottle of supplements and I'm thinking about taking it. What do you think, doc? When they are met with utter resistance and told, like, oh, it doesn't work. Oh, don't try it. I don't know anything about it. It might be dangerous. That's not doing them fair justice as a patient. You know, they are taking a step to say, hey, I'm empowering my own wellness. And so we've got to be respectful and non-judgmental. And then I think that the other thing that we have to do is explain the science that we know. When we don't know, say that. If you've never heard of these herbs and supplements, then just say that, and that's okay. But then commit to doing a bit of research. You know, be it following somebody as simple as me on my blog and just going, I wonder if there's some writings about this, or is it simply looking up that supplement online while they're in your office? I know when I was practicing pharmacy, patients would bring me medications all the time directly from the shelf, and they'd say, how do I take this? I can't tell you how many times I just turned the bottle around and read the instructions to them. And so once we open dialogue, are respectful of the patient's choices, explain what we know, then we are at a point when we can collaborate with them. You know, if you've got a patient on a blood thinning medicine and they bring you a supplement that has garlic and ginkgo, and you just go, wow, this is a lot of drug interactions going on. If they're committed and they're like, doc, I'm going to take this no matter what you say, then it's up to you as the care provider to say, all right, well, then that means that for the next 6 weeks, I need you to commit to taking it every day. And I need you to commit to coming in and getting your INR checked more frequently. That collaboration and that compromise and negotiation is how we can empower our patients to safely use herbs and supplements and essential oils alongside their medicines. And it also helps you as a care provider know that you are doing what you are mandated by your license, by your ethics and principles to take care of that person.
Would you say that you are an alternative pharmacist in that you try to integrate as opposed to eliminate one or the other?
I think that there is a place for herbs, supplements, natural remedies, and I think that there is definitely a place for medication. I am not someone who is going to say there's only this one way. My opinion on everything in life, not just healthcare, but on everything is there is no right choice. There is no wrong choice. There is only the choice that you make. And if that, for some people, means I'm going to take every medicine that I'm given, I'm never going to use an alternative, I'm never going to explore, I'm never going to change my diet, that's one choice. On the absolute opposite end of the spectrum are the people that say, you know what, I am never going to take a medicine. I don't care if my blood pressure is high. I'm going to get some magnesium supplements and I'm going to start meditating and I'm going to eliminate caffeine from my diet. And that's going to be my choice. I think both of those are valid. I certainly am against the culture of shame within the natural product community. And I'm a very avidly outspoken about it among my peers, is if you're in this community and somebody gets a rip-roaring pneumonia and chooses to take an antibiotic, or if someone gets terrible postpartum depression and chooses to take an antidepressant, that is their choice. And that is totally a valid choice. I think that there is room for conventional approaches, and I think that both are valid solutions to health.
Well, where can we go and learn more online about your point of view and about essential oils as they relate to our wellness overall?
Absolutely. So you can find me online at www.lindsayelmore.com. You can also find me on Facebook and Instagram at Lindsay Elmore.
Thank you so much for coming in and speaking with us today, Dr. Elmore. It's been a pleasure.
Absolutely. It was my joy, my honor, and I hope that everyone takes away just one small thing that can help inform their practice.
You've been listening to Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neil Howard. Transcripts and audio of this program are available at healthprofessionalradio.com.au and also at hpr.fm. Subscribe to the podcast on iTunes, listen in and download at SoundCloud, and visit our affiliates page at hpr.fm and healthprofessionalradio.com.au.
Thank you for listening to Health Professional Radio. We're very proud to be an independent broadcaster providing our content free of charge to you, the listener. One of the ways that we're able to remain free and independent is by having people like you become patrons. You can support Health Professional Radio simply by visiting hpr.fm and clicking the button that says Become a Patron. Your patronage of even just $1 a month lets us know that you're there, which in turn makes us more valuable to advertisers. And, of course, if you're able to afford more, then we would certainly appreciate the support. My name is Toby Longhurst from Health Professional Radio. Please visit hpr.fm, click the Become a Patron button, and support us if you can.